key.
No.
Definitely not again.
Please, not.
Sorry.
Oh, you're gonna be sorry.
Woke you guys up, didn't it?
No, yeah.
Yes, she is.
So this is one of my favorite prayers, really. It's a love song to the body and the soul. And if you've been following our learnings for the last few years, you'll recognize this idea of Walt Whitman and his celebration of the body and all of its magnificence, and that the body and the soul are not separate. Many times you'll hear, especially in the Lushan of the New Age, the lingo of the New Age, that we are souls inhabiting bodies, right? So this is not a Jewish idea. It's not even an idea of mine, really. And Whitman, he also disavows this notion. He says that we are souls, right, that have inhabited a body that has become a part of the soul, because wherever the soul inhabits, wherever it takes residence, it becomes adhered to, that vehicle, and it's not separate anymore. And the body, right, it does make so much sense, and the body has its own wisdom.
Right.
We used to think that the body was just a lump of flesh, and then all reasoning came from the mind, and that's also an antiquated idea. You respond, even in states of emergency, right, survival mode, you respond with your body. It's proven faster than you do with your mind. Before your mind can you compute. So there's a wisdom there, and it should be respected. Because that's how, say that again? My body is my temple. Yes, body. My body rides over the ocean. You know, the smaller the group, the cornier we get. Am I right, Bob? Am I right?
Just bring back my body. That's
what it comes down to.
Please.
Please. He has an easy problem.
Please, yes, please. Yeah. Thank you, Peggy.
A little more whistle, okay. Please, Doc.
Anyways, so, and this is important, we tend to think of ourselves, in this is all about slicha, we tend to think of ourselves in a binary way, that there are good aspects and bad aspects to the person, to the self. And that also couldn't be further from the truth, and further from the liturgy of this particular service, slichot service. And so I want to translate this prayer for you. It's Hanashama Lach. Hanashama Lach. That's it. You got it? So it's here, it's translated. I'll move out of the way so you can see it. My soul is yours, and my body is your work. And then the next line is, please show your affection to what's yours. And traditionally we understand this to mean, you know, God, please this year, as Paula said, you know, one of our disappointments is our disappointments and our physical limitations. So we pray to God, please let me ride out this year without too many physical issues. And it's also spoken by the self. It's important for us to love what we're given, to love how we're created, to love all of our quirks and our issues, all of our protrusions and our prolapses, all of our frailties, you know? And even our shortcomings. So, when we say, please show your affection to what's yours, we really mean for you to show affection, to love yourself. And that's never an idea that's antiquated. So, if you would sing with me, it's in the minor keys.
Oh, Thank you.
You know, truth be told, it's not really part of the Slichus service, this Tikkun Shlom. You know, sometimes you need it.
Yeah.
When we're about to go into uncharted territory, it's always good to have a shema. Yeah. So be seated just for a moment.